Happy Brexitmas! The United Kingdom is withdrawal from the European Aviation Safety Agency EASA system. The UK is out of the open European skies. Can you believe that? At 11 p.m. on the 31st of December 2020, while you were celebrating the New Year's Eve, the UK left the European Union aviation system, and as such is no longer part of the European Union aviation institutions, including the European Union Aviation Safety Agency, EASA. Are you a private pilot, commercial pilot, wish to become a pilot, cabin crew, aircraft maintenance engineer, a flight school owner, or commercial air transport operator? Don't go anywhere, because I'm going to tell you the effect of the UK withdrawal from the EASA system on you. Additionally, I'm providing a piece of advice to everyone who wants to become a pilot at the end of the video. Hello everyone, this is Aly Bayoumy, and I'm your captain today. So, fasten your seatbelt, joy mode on, learning mode on, and we are ready for takeoff. European Union law no longer applies to the United Kingdom. That means that mutual recognition of safety certificates and licenses between the UK and the European system came to an end on the 31st of December 2020. First, impact for pilots. EASA side. If you are a holder of a UK pilot license, flight instructor or flight examiner rating, unfortunately, your UK issued pilot license, rating and a medical certificate will be considered as a third country license and the certificate as of January 1st, 2021. What does that mean? Your license is no longer recognized for flying and no longer valid to operate an aircraft in an EASA member state as of January 1st, 2021. Additionally, the UK issued examiner certificates is no longer accepted in the EU to conduct skill test, proficiency check, or assessment of competence for the issue, revalidation, or renewal of an EASA Party FCL license, rating, or certificate. So, you will need to convert your license into an EU license, and you will also need a Part-Med medical certificate issued by an EASA member state competent authority. Now, the UK Civil Aviation Authority side. CAA will issue a general validation allowing EASA license holders to fly UK registered aircraft within the privileges of the license, rating, and certificates. A 2 years acceptance period will be implemented allowing the use of EASA licenses, ratings, certificates, approvals, and declarations. For example, an EASA flight instructor rating holder can work at a UK flight school and train students for UK licenses. If you have a question regarding the conversion or validation processes and the difference between both of them, please leave me a comment. Second point of today's topic, impact for cabin crew approvals at stations. EASA side, from January 1st, 2021, cabin crew attestation issued by the UK will no longer be valid and mutually recognized for use on an aircraft operated by a commercial air transport operator certified by an EASA member state. UKCAA side, EASA issued cabin crew attestations valid on the 31st of December 2020 will be recognized by the UKCAA for working on UK registered aircraft for up to 2 years. After that, operator for UK registered aircraft will need to issue a crew currently holding EASA attestation with the UK ones. Third, impact for aircraft maintenance engineers. EASA side. engineers wanting to work on an AO registered aircraft will need to get an EASA member state license. As of January 1st, 2021, Part 66 licenses previously issued by UK authorities will no longer be valid and recognized in EU. CAA side. The CAA will allow engineers with licenses issued by other EASA member states and valid on the 31st of December 2020 to maintain UK registered aircraft for up to 2 years. The fourth point of today's topic, impacts on training organizations. EASA side. Current ATOs and DTOs under the oversight of the UKCAA will no longer be recognized as holding an EASA approval or declaration by the European Union. This means that the training courses offered will be for the issue of UK licenses, ratings, and certificates only. This is really a huge impact on flight schools in the UK. Should an organization wish to continue offering to European Union clients, will be required to seek a third country ATO approval from EASA under direct oversight. CAA side. There are no plans to change the EASA regulations related to ATOs and DTOs. All requirements will remain under the UK Civil Aviation Regulations. The fifth and the last point of today's topic, impact on airlines. European Union is a single state for trade purposes, so AO registered aircraft can conduct a commercial operation freely within any other member state. As an example, a German commercial air transport operator can operate freely at any AO member state. EASA side. As of January 1st, 2021, the UK certified commercial air transport operators have been considered as third country operators, TCO, and required to hold a valid EASA TCO authorization to be able to conduct commercial air transport operations into, within, or out of the territory to which the AO treaties apply. A list of the UK operators that issued a TCO authorization on the 31st of December 2020 is available on the EASA website, which can be found in the description. UKCAA side. European Union registered the airlines operating in the UK will also need a third country or a foreign carrier approval to operate in the UK. In the end, before you decide to become a pilot in the UK or the European Union or join a flight school, please consider the consequences of Brexit. Complete guidance on how to become a pilot will be published on my YouTube channel soon. Stay tuned! That's all for me today. You're absolutely lovely. Wait! We are going to land! Landing checklist. Subscription? On. Notification bell? Set. Comments and questions as required. Like and dislike as required. Landing checklist completed.